Hi, my name is Mark Driscoll, and I'm one of the pastors at Mars Hill Church. Good Friday is the somber day that we remember what we did to God. And it culminates with Easter Sunday, where we remember what God did for us. Part of the issue with Good Friday is emotionally connecting with the substitutionary death of Jesus in our place for our sins. The Bible gives us scant details of exactly how Jesus died, and that is perhaps because in his day, many people were witnesses to crucifixion. Now that we are lacking that kind of firsthand experience, we at Mars Hill felt it would be helpful to show you what crucifixion looks like, and the beatings and scourgings which preceded were in fact like. And so we sent a film crew to capture footage. We filmed our own piece of material that is theologically based on the teaching of the Bible, and that will be the majority of our Good Friday presentation. We want you to somberly view it as if you were sitting at a funeral, watching the death of the most important man in the history of the world, the man who was and is, in fact, God, our Lord Jesus Christ. We would then encourage you to spend the ensuing days remembering specific sins in your life, the ways that you have failed to honor and glorify God in thought, word, deed, and motive. And then we would invite you on Easter Sunday, as Jesus got out of his grave, to also get out of your bed and get out of your house and to find a Bible teaching church where Jesus is made much of. If you're near a Mars Hill campus or an Acts 29 church, we'd love to have you join us. But as long as you gather with God's people to remember God's Son, we would rejoice in that. Lastly, there will not be a typical sermon for this presentation. And if you have more questions about exactly why Jesus died and what he accomplished, I would encourage you to read the book, Death by Love.
Knowing what was to come, Jesus was troubled in his spirit, and he said to his disciples,
"Truly I say to you, one of you will betray me, one of you who is eating with me. The Son of Man goes as it is written, but woe to that man by whom the Son of Man is betrayed. It would have been better off if that man had not been born."
"Lord, who is he?"
"It is he to whom I give this morsel of bread."
At that moment, Satan entered into Judas.
"What you're going to do, do quickly." Take, eat. For this is my body, which is given to you. Do this in remembrance of me. Drink of it, for this is my blood of the covenant, poured out for many for the forgiveness of sins. I say to you, I will not drink of the fruit of this vine until that day I drink it new with you in my Father's kingdom. Satan demanded to have you, that he might sift you like wheat. But I prayed for you, that your faith may not fail. When you've turned back again, strengthen your brothers.
Lord, I am ready to follow you both to prison and to death.
Peter, I say to you, the rooster will not crow this day until you deny three times you know me. Stay here while I go over there and pray.
Jesus took with him Peter, James, and John. As they walked, Jesus became greatly distressed and troubled.
Stay here. Keep watch with me. Abba, Father, all things are possible for you. Remove this cup from me. Nevertheless, not my will, but yours be done. Peter, are you asleep? Could you not watch 1 hour? Watch and pray that you do not enter into temptation. The spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak.
And again, Jesus went away and prayed. And being in agony, Jesus prayed more earnestly, and his sweat became like drops of blood falling down to the ground. The high priest paid Judas 30 pieces of silver to betray Jesus. So he led a crowd of soldiers into the garden seeking to arrest him.